17, I was 40.
What?
Ooh, okay, hey man, ever hear of Me Too? And he is getting testier and testier at the press, at least some parts of it, zero in on his family's corrupt dealings with Ukraine. Dumb question? Well, maybe, maybe not. And also, he's just been rambling on about how he's been keeping classified documents around his house for almost 50 years.
So, and the best of my knowledge, the kinds of things they picked up are things that from 1974 and stray papers. There may be something else I don't know.
Okay, then. Well, look, all of this stuff is, and I'm going to go out on a limb here, all this stuff is, if you ask me, a desperate cry for help from a man who no longer wants to be president and is just amping up the weird behavior in the hope that someone, please, at the New York Times editorial board gets the message and starts running helpful explainer pieces on the 25th Amendment. That's the one, by the way, that provides for the removal of a president who is, shall we say, incapacitated. But, you know, the big problem here, right? What comes next? Who would the Democrats put in his place? I mean, sure, the most likely pick is Kamala Harris.
Happy Juneteenth. Please have a seat. Please have a seat. To my Divine Nine family. Good evening, everyone.
Wow, well, what are they putting in the Girl Scout cookies these days anyway? But there are other possible contenders, one of them being California Governor Gavin Newsom, another likely candidate. And indeed, he's already been out fighting a bit of a proxy war on behalf of the president against potential Republican challenger Ron DeSantis.
The trans issue has come on as a more divisive issue in the context, particularly of sports, where right. It's also been weaponized, and issues around pronouns. I remember the first time I was on Zoom, and all of a sudden I saw these different pronouns, and that even took me. I was like, what's this? Mm-hmm. I didn't fully understand that. I think a combination of those factors, the weaponization of grievance and dehumanization that I see of politicians that are exploiting this, like Ron DeSantis notably, but not unique to DeSantis, have also exacerbated this.
Ah, yes, weaponization. Biological males in women's change rooms and competing against them on the sporting field, all just weaponization. Glad you're woke about your pronouns, though. And here's what Governor Gavin Newsom had to say about the fact that massive retailers, including now a giant Westfield mall, are all shutting up shop in San Francisco.
I think they're struggling to recover from the pandemic. They're struggling to come back. They're struggling with the macroeconomic shifts, particularly as it relates to telework, as it relates to what's the future of a downtown. Is it stacking of offices or stacking of people?
It's all those just old macroeconomic challenges in San Francisco. But that's a kind of a funny way to describe, you know, homeless encampments and open-air needle drug use and rampant violent crime and carjackings on the street of a once great city. Now, even if he doesn't wind up on the ticket, Gavin Newsom is going to wind up being a massive ambassador for the Biden campaign, which is why we're talking about him today, and which is going to do as much as possible to keep the president's under wraps. Listen here to Newsom defending Biden in a chat with Fox News' Sean Hannity.
I want you to tell me that you think he is cognitively strong enough to lead this country against China, Russia, Iran, North Korea, and a new axis of evil, and that he's the guy. He cannot articulate the economy the way you just did.
Yeah, but I don't think he's capable. I know he's capable. I see results. I've seen a masterclass in results.
Masterclass in results from Joe Biden. This is what Gavin Newsom is saying. Well, to that
17, I was 40.
What?
Woo! Okay. Hey, man, ever hear of Me Too? And he is getting testier and testier at the press, at least some parts of it, zero in on his family's corrupt dealings with Ukraine.